Now, to forbear forever so little of Irish trees and lily orangans, concerning the genesis of Harold or Humphrey Chimpton's occupational agnomen, we are back in the pre-surnames on Roman Erith period, of course just when Enos chalked tall traps, and discarding once for all those theories from older sources which would link him back with such pivotal ancestors as the Glues, the Gravis, the Northeast, the Yankers, and the Earwickers of Siddleshelm in the Hundred of Manhood, or proclaim him offspring of Vikings who had founded Wapentake and settled him in Herrick or Herrick. The best authenticated version, the Dumlat, read the reading of Hofed Ben Eder, has it that it was this way. We are told how in the beginning it came to pass that like cabbaging Cincinnatus, the grand old gardener was saving daylight under his redwood tree one sultry Sabbath afternoon, had Chivicus Eve in pre-fall paradise peace by following his plow for riddles in the rear garden of Mob House, the old Marine Hotel, when royalty was announced by Runner to have been pleased to have halted itself on the high road along with a leisure-loving dog fox, had cast followed also at walking pace by a lady pack of Cocker Spaniels, forgetful of all save vassals' plain fealty to the ethnarch Humphrey or Harold, stayed not to yoke or saddle, but stumbled out hot-faced as he was, his spitful bandana loose from his pocket coat, hastening to the forecourts of his public in tupi, shirklings, sole of scarf and plaid, plus fours, putties and bulldog boots, ruddled cinnabar with flagrant marl, jangling his turnpike keys and bearing aloft amid the fixed pikes of the hunting party a high perch atop of which a flower pot was fixed erstide hoist with hair. On his majesty, who was, or often feigned to be, noticeably long-sighted from green youth, and had been meaning to inquire what, in effect, had caused young Causeway to be thus potholed, asked substitutionally to be put wise as to whether Paternoster and Silver Doctors were not now more fancied bait for lobster trapping. Honest, blunt Harum Friedel answered in no uncertain tones very similarly with a fearless forehead, "Nah, ya muggers! Ah, we're just a catchin' on thumb, looky here, wuggers." Our sailor king, who was draining a googlet of obvious atom ale, gif, both, and garbin, upon this sea seemed to swallow, smiled most heartily beneath his walrus mustache, and indulging the none too genial humor with William the Conk on the spindle side, and inherited with a heredity white lock and some short-fingeredness from his great Aunt Sophie, turned towards two of his retinue of gallow glasses, Michael, Etheling Lord of Lakes, and Offaly, and the Jubilee Mayor of Drogheda, Elcock, the two scatterguns being Michael M. Manning, proto-syndic of Waterford, and an Italian excellency named Giubielli, according to a later version cited by the learned scholar Canavan of Can Make Noise. In either case, a triptychal religious family symbolizing Puritas of Doctrina, business per usuals, and a punchy patch of hemlock where the paddle pretties grow, and remark dulcely,
"Holy bones of St. Hubert! How our red brother of Porin Grania would audibly fume did he know that we have for Sir Trusty Bailiwick a term piker who is by turns a pike bailer no seldomer than an ear wicker. For he kinned John Pill with his court so gray and his haunts and his hounds in the morning. One still hears that pebble crust a laffa, the jippy jap cherry cheerily among the roadside tree the lady home Patrick planted, and still one feels the emotive silence of the clanstone Halle belling, I've me's oaties born." Comes the question, are Are these the facts of his nomingentilization as recorded and accoladed in both or either of the collateral Andrew Paul Murphy narratives? Are those their fata which we read in Sibylline between the fas and its nefas? No dung on the road, and shall Nehemiah be a place like, yay, Malkami, our king of Okan? We shall perhaps not so soon see. Ping pongs that bail forsakes a license. Where come scepters with centaurs stay? Bear in mind, son of Hokmah, if so be you have mythic in your midness, this man is mountain and unto changes doth one ascend. Heave we aside the fallacy as punical as Finnegan, that it was not the king himself, but his inseparable sisters, uncontrollable night talker, skirts erased and Donya hazed, who afterwards, when the robber shot up the socialites, came down into the world as amusers and were staged by Madame Sublov as Rosa and Lily Miskingwet in the Palatine, the two Pitts patronos, Miliadorus and Galate. The great act emerges that after that historic date, all holographs so far exhumed, initialed by Humphrey, bear the sigla HCE. And while he was only a long and always good Duke Humphrey, for the hungerling spalpings of little Lois and Chambers to his cronies, it was equally certainly a pleasant turn of the populace, which gave him a sense of those normative letters, the nickname, here comes everybody, an imposing everybody. He always indeed looked constantly the same as and equal to himself, and magnificently well worthy of any and all such universalization. Every time he continually surveyed amid vociferatings from in front of accept these few hoodies and hit off at white hat, he leave with doctor's grog and put it in the log and loots in his vassal local boots. From good start to happy finish, the truly Catholic assemblage gathered together in that King Street house of satin lustre-like, above floats and footlights from their us ball belts and ox gangs unanimously to Clopard, the inspiration of his lifetime and the hits of their careers, Mr. Wallenstein Washington Semper Kelly's Immergreen Tourers, in a command performance by special request, with the courteous permission for pious purposes, the home-drummed and enlivened performance of Problem Passion Play of the Millinery, running strong since creation. A royal divorce, then near the approach toward the summit of its climates, with ambitious interval band selections from the Bow Girl and the Lily, on all horsery show command lights from his vice-regal booth, his bossel owner is sealing there a cuckoo spit less eminent than the red ritual hoods of Maccabee and Column, where a veritable Napoleon the Nth, our world stage practical joke piece and retired Sekelty co-commendian, in his own wise this folks for father, all of the time sat having the entirety of his house about him, with the invariable broad stretched kerchief cooling his whole neck, nape and shoulder blades, and in a wardrobe paneled tuxedo completely thrown back from a shirt well entitled A Swallowall, on every point far out starching the laundered claw hammers and marble topped highboys of the pit stalls and early amphitheater. The piece was this, look at the lamps, the cast was thus, see under the clock, ladies circle, hoax may be left, pit, Palmer and Parterre, standing room only, habituals conspicuously emergent. A baser meaning hath been read into these characters, the literal sense of which decency can safely scarcely hint.
It hath been blurtingly bruited by certain wise crackers, the stings of Marwan are in the night plots of the morning, that he suffered from a vile disease. Athma, unmanner them. To such a suggestion, the one self-respecting answer is to affirm that these are certain statements which ought not to be, and one should like to hope to be able to add, ought not to be allowed to be made. Nor have his detractors, who, an imperfectly warm-blooded race, apparently conceive him as a great white caterpillar capable of any and every enormity in the calendar recorded, to the discredit of the Duke and the Kelly Keck families, mended their case by insinuating that, alternately, he lay at one time under the ludicrous imputation of annoying Welsh fusiliers in the People's Park. Hey, 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 hawk, 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 fawn and flora on the lee love, that little old jock, to anyone who knew and loved the Christ-likeness of the big, clean-minded giant H.C. Earwicker throughout his excellency, long vice-regal existence, the mere suggestion of him as a lust-sleuth nosing for trouble in a booby trap rings particularly preposterous. Truth, beard on prophet, compels one to add that there is said to have been quondam pfuit, some case of the kind of implicating it is interdum believed a quindam. If he did not exist, it would be necessary quornium to invent him. A poot that time stumbling around, dumbling in leaky sneakers with his tark record, who has remained topantically anonymous. But let us hew him Abdullah Gamal Aksarski, was, it is stated, posted at Mellon's at the instance of watch warriors of the Vigilance Committee, and years afterward, cries one even greater Ibid, a commander of the frightful, seemingly, unto such as were solhensated, propped head, befeat, waiting his first of the month frauds, turn for that chop-bat kabax, alikubi on the house, for the charge-hard roach haddocks of Hawkins Street. Lo, you blondy liar, Gob seen you in the darkened place, and she that eateth her home defileth these boils. There's a cabful of bash indeed in the homer of that meal. Flander, let it lie its flattest, hath never been able to convict our good and great and no ordinary Southern Earwicker. That homogeneous man, as pious other call him, of any graver impropriety than that advanced by some Woodsworths or regarders, who did not dare deny the Shomers that they had chin-ted, chin-tam, chin-chin-taffied, that they consumed their soul of the corn, and having behaved with ungentlemanly immodus opposite a pair of dainty maid-servants in the swath of the rushy hollow wither, or so the two gown and piners, leading dame nature in all innocency, had spontaneously in about the same hour of the eventide sent them both, but whose published combinations of silken lane testimonies are, where not dubiously pure, visibly divergent as rap from wet on minor points, touching the intimate nature of this, a first offense in vert or venison, which was admittedly an incautious, but at its wildest, an impartial exposure, with such attenuating circumstances, garneth, canneth, green, worse, hookman, brideth, girling, as an abnormal St. Swithin's summer, and
Jazzy's Rose of Sharon, a ripe occasion to provoke it.
We can't do without them. Wives, rush to the rest stores. Off man, well, two men, while lead is the law. Zeddids are Cadam, Villapeach, Volapuk, Fickup, or Flesh, Nelly, El Mundo No, Zolly Flynn. If she's a Lilith, pull early. Pauline, allow. The mailers ambush, keep black, keep black. Guiltless of much made to him, he was clearly, for once at least, he clearly expressed himself as being with still a trace of his erewhile burr, and hence it has been received of us that it is true. They tell the story, an amalgam as absorbing as calcium chlorides and hydrophobia sponges could make it. How one happy go gusty Ides of April morning, the anniversary, as it fell out of his assumption of his birthday suit, and rights in appertance to the confusioning of human races, ages and ages after the alleged misdemeanor, when the tried friend of all creation, Tigerwood road staff to his stay, was billowing across the wide expanse of our greatest park in his couch at Cap. And great belt and hide and sacks and his blow funks fustian and iron rods, jack boots and bagafat gaiters and his rubberized Inverness. He met a cad with a pipe, the latter the Luciferent, not the Oriolate, who, as odds are, is still burning bag about in the same straw bamer, carrying his overcoat under his shoulder, sheepside out so as to look more like a Humphrey gentleman, and signing the pledge as gaily as you please, hardly accosted him with, when it saw tool and Jew me dinner oozle fiend, a nice how do you do in pool black at the time, as some of our old azers may still trembling recall, to ask could he tell him how much o'clock it was that the clock struck, had he any idea by cock's luck, as his watch was brightest, hesitancy was clearly to be evitated, execration as cleverly to be honesoid. The ear worker at that spurring instant, realizing on fundamental liberal principles the supreme importance nextually and noctually of physical life, an ear's help relay being ping ping KO St. Patrick's Day and defending and rising, and unwishful as he felt of being hurled into eternity right then, plugged by a soft-nosed bullet from the sap, halted quick on the draw and replying that he was feeling dip stuff, kill, produced from his gun pocket his Jergensen's shrapnel waterberry, ours by communionism, his by use you capture, but on the same stroke hearing above the skirling of harsh mother east old Fox Goodman, the bellmaster, over the wastes to south, at work upon the 10-ton tinuin, thunderous tenor taller in the speckled church, Cahoon's call, hold the inquiring kidder, by Jehovah, it was 12 of them sidereal, and tankard time, adding but tall, as he bended deeply with smoke sardinish breath, to give more pondus to the copper stick he presented, though this seems in some confusion with the chopstuck ginger, which, as being of sours, acids, salts, sweets, and bitters, compounded, we know him to have used this cha-cha for bone, muscle, blood, flesh, and dim vital. That whereas the Hakusei accusation against him had been made, what was known in high quarter, as was stood stated in Morgan's post, by a creature in human form, who was quite beneath par and several degrees lower than your triple hydrate snake. In greater support of his word, in quaint anticipation of a famous phrase has been reconstricted out of oral style into the verbal for all time with ritual rhythmics, in quiritary quietude, and to cements duct from successive accounts by Noah Webster in the redaction known as the sayings attributive of H.C. Earwicker, prize on shillings, postlets free, deflection
Jiggus tapped his chronometrum dum-drum, and now standing full erect above the Abbey Jensen floodplain scene of its happening, with one Berlin Gotland chop stuck in the hoof of his elbage by ancientest singlore, his gesture meaning it pointed at an angle of 32 degrees towards his duc de fer, overgrown milestone as fellow to his gauge, and after a rendy present pause, averred with solemn emotion's fire, "Shh, Sheikh Cocomeride, me only them 5-1s, he is equal combat, I have one strike. Hence my nomination, wide hotel and creamery establishments, which for the honors of our Mew Mew mutual daughters credit me, I am woo-woo willing to take my stand, sir, upon the monument that signs of our rural redemption, any hygienic day to this hour, and to make my hope to my sin finners, even if I get life for it, upon the open Bible, and before the great taskmasters, if I lift my hat, and in the presence of the deity itself, and well of Bishop and Mrs. Micken of High Church of England, as of all such have said, my immediate withwellers, and of every living soul in every corner whatsoever of this globe in general, which viewedest of my British to my backbone tongue, and communicative justice, that there is not one tittle of truth, allow me to tell you, in the purest of fib-fib fabrications."
Gaping gill, swift to mate ethers, stern to check self, diagnosing through eustatube that it was to make a markedly postpubertal hypertituary type of Heidelberg manly cavern ethics, lofted his sloping forward, bad sweat agore, good morrow, and double notch on it, as he was greedily obliged, and like a sensible hand, with infinite tact in the delicate situation, seeing the touchy nature of its perilous theme, thanked them for guilders received in time of day, not a little token of balk, all the same, that was how the God's clock it was, and upon humble duty to greet his disc minister, and he shall gild the gap caper, and the his emoldy voids went about his business, whoever it was, saluting corpses as a matter of course. One could hound him out had one heart to four, the monticules of Sculp and Dundra dropping blaze his trail, accompanied by his trusty snarler and his permanent reflection, "Verbi gracious, I have met you, bird, too late, or if not, too warm and early." And with tag for Ildiot, repeated in his second month languages, many of the big-timer's verbatim words which he could boldly call to memory, that same cavaltive ere the hour of the twattering of bards in the Twitter litter between Druidia and the deep slee sea, when supper tide and souvenir to Charlatan Mall jointly came gently, and along the quiet darkening of grand and royal footman's fluff and crept at hedge, when as to many a soft tongue's pocky talk mood answer and softer puff yoff of wonder always acquiescent, while studying castles in the blown and studying cow shots over the Doran, he spat in careful convertedness a mosaic dispensation about his heart own, if you please, Irish saliva, mochshid ochul, but would a respectable, prominently connected fellow of Iro-European ascendances with well-dressed ideas who knew the correct things, such as Mr. Shall We Sigh, or Mr. Shall We Laugh, expectorate after such a callous fashion, no thank yous, when he had his belcher's sucker tuck in his pocket, punk. Muse fed with his buckets after having supped of the dish salt and pottage, which he snobbishly dubbed Peach Bombay. It is rarely only lookin' pukin' Pilsen pie, which she knows, which sent off and biped him as supreme of excelling peas, balled under men's hogs' milk into white malt, wine sour, a proviant the little bilker hoarsely relished, chaffet in the snivel season, being as fain aught as your rat with fennel. And on this celebrating occasion of the happy escape, for a crowning of potvalians, this regional platter, Benjamin of Bullis, with a spoilish olive to middle point its zenith, was marrying itself porco grasso, air bust very delectuously, with a bottle of Finnish Bruyere 98, followed for second nuptials by a piss porter, Grand Cour, of both of which cherished table lights, though humble the bouquet. To Suleiman's farewell, he obdurately sniffed the cobwebs crusted corks. Arcad's bit of strife, the Bernice Mex Wilden, with a quick ear for spittoons, as the aftertale hath it, clanged up as usual with domestic husbandry. No persics or millions for thee, Pomerantia, but slipping the clove in her claw, broke of the matter among 111 others in her usual curtsy. How faint these first vespers womanly are! A secret pispiliando, arm in the lover dee, den of their manfolker. The next night, nudge one as was Aegisipus over a hoop of chee, her eyes dry and small, and speech thicklish, because he appeared a funny color, like he couldn't stood the old hens any longer. To her peculiar reverend, the director, whom she had been meaning in her mind primarily to speak with, Oshintla, just a thimble spoon, trusting between cupped lips and any Lowry promises, might she never have Esnekary pudding come Hanaval, for her peckle lappishness, that the gospel so delivered in his epistolier, buried teetostally in their Irish stew, would go no further than his Jesuit's cloth. Yet in Venaris Vitas Volatiles Valetotum, it was this overspoiled priest, Mr. Brown, disguised as a Vincentian, who, when seized of the facts, was overheard in his secondary personality as a Nolan and unreared told soul by accident. If that is the incident, it was an accident, for here the ruler of Ecclesiastes of Hippo outpasts the riches of Hava Banana, till pianissime a slightly varied version of the Cribs confidentials, what Mera Hoshi said, but for Jesufine's sake, hands between hands, in fealty sworn, my braver best, my frar, and to the strains of the secret of her birth, hushly pierced the rubrian aurelium of one Philly Thurnstom, a lay teacher of rural science and orthophonetics, of a near stout figure and about the middle of his 40s, during a priestly flutter of safe and sane bets at the hippic root field of Greasy Mud Oil. On a date, WW goes to the card, easily capable of remembrance by all pickers up of events, national and Dublin details. The doubles of Perkin and Pollock, Peer and Prole, when the classical encourage Hackney plate was captured by two noses in a stable cloth finish. Eck and neck, some and none, Evelo Nevelo, from the cream colt bold boy Cromwell after a clever getaway by Captain Chaplain Blount's Row Heiny St. Dolph Rummer Coxon Depicter at Break Lake Odds, thanks to you, great little bunny little porty little Winnie Widger. You're all their nappies, who, in his never red mud and purpular cap with shirly legs, unlike any other phantom weight that ever toppled our timber maggies.
"'Twas too pisen on tin coffees, the weather is past, the ends are overt in command, the volex of the turfer is hurled on our land. Of the name of Treacle Tom, as was just out of pop, following the theft of a leg of Keowee, Donnelly and Packham's finished pork, and his own blood and milk brother Frisky Shorty. He was to be exquisitely punctilious about them, both Shorty and Frisky, a tipster. Come off the hulks, both of them awful bore, but was out on the bum around, full of bird game, if for a jimmy old goblin, a small thick earnest chance, while the sea forest was making the calling ball, to hear the passon of the motor clubber make use of his law language, Enzo on, touching the case of Mr. Adams, what was in all the Sundays about it, which he was rubbing noses with, and having a gurgle off his own along of the buddy bloke in the specs. This Treacle Tom, to whom reverence has been made, has been absent from his usual wild and woolly haunts in the land of counties Capolines for some time previous to that. He was, in fact, in the habit of frequenting common lodging houses, where he slept in a nude state. Hail, fellow with meth and strange men's guts! But on race night, lotto after divers tots of hellfire, red biddy bulldog, blue ruin and creeping Jenny, Eglinton's choices herbage, supplied by the duck and doggies, the galloping primrose, Bridget Brewster's the cock, the postboy's horn, the little old man's an all swell that aims well, the cup in the stirrup he sought his well-warmed, libabobbed in a housing room, abide with one another at lot WW. Why did he back it? Comport the liberties, and what with a mocha puke, convolta puke, restored alcohol inherently to the burden of, I come, my horse delayed, num, num. The substance of the tale of the evangelical Bussy Bossy and the ruinous Serbine. The girls he would keep calling them for the collaret and skirt, the sunbonnet and carnation. In parts, it seemed he was before the eons of Martes or other whales, the thirds of fossil years. He having beham with Katya when Lavinia's had her men's lease to see in a sumship doodly show, whereat he was looking for fight beggars with wild roses. Oft in the chilly night, the metagonistic, the epigothalamoros, during uneasy slumber in their hearing of a small and stony brook, cash draper's executive, Peter Claren, discharged, O'Mara, an ex-private secretary of no fixed abode, locally known as Mildew Lisa, who had passed several nights furnished off in the doorway under the blankets of homelessness on the bunk of Iceland, pillowed upon the stone of destiny, colder than man's knee or woman's breast, and hosty, no such of a name, an ill-starred beach busker, who, sans Rudy and sans Scrapey, suspicioning as how he was sitting on a twidstool on the verge of self-abyss, most starved with melancholia over everything in general, nightmare menu served him nauticals nano, had been towhead tossing on his shakedown, devising ways and manners of means of
what he loved to infit a license somehow or other in the nation, getting a hold of some chap's parabolon in the hope of taking a wing sociable and lighting upon beside wheel dive somewhere off the dull key down Mary and bleak rookie tramline, where he can throw true and go and blow the civis title napper off himself for 2 bits to boldy well multitude in the peace and quinnibus of a one sure shot bottle, he having had been trying all he knew with the lady's help of Madam Bristol for upward of 18 calendars to get out of Sir Patrick Dunn's, through Sir Humphrey Jervis and into the St. Kevin's Bed in the Adelaide's hospitals, from these incurable Wellesleys among those uncurable Wellesleys through Santiago by his cockle hat, good Lazard, deliver us without after having been able to jerry-wangle it any sides, Lisa O'Devis and Roach Mungan, who had so much in common episecondilically, if the phrase be permitted, hostess et odor in super petro for fractus, as an understood thing slept their sleep of the Swinburne in the one sweet undulant mother of tumbler bunks, with hostages now the shavers in the shaw, the yokels in the yokes are well, the wasters in the wild and the bustling twinny dawn of all works, me the anthems here we pat, had not been many jiffies furbishing pot lids, door brasses, scholars' apple cheeks, and link points medals when ash-hopper minded like no fella, here go make back and beg fuss long a white man, the rejuvenator busker, for after a good night's rave and rumble and a shink ham's top morning with his coexies, he was not the same man, and his broad awake bedroom suite, our boys, as our iron called them, were up in a shuffle from the hogs home they loved in the barrel, cross Eblin's chilled tablet, rice root, and resting on their then superficies curiously correspondent with those linea and puncta, where are too many ha-benny metro-manny plums below the arbor flake under rails and stations at this time of writing, to the rumbling of a crude fiddle, which cromoning and cronoming, levy gravy, witty and wavy, happy, leppy and playable, caress the ears of the subjects of King Saint Finnerty the Festive, who, in brick homes of their own and in their flavored raised berry beds, heeding hardly cry of honey man, so with lavender or foin boing salmon alive, with their priggish mouths all open for the larger appreciation of this long-awaited messiah of oratorios, where only half-assed at sweep and after a wrist falls at a pawn-broking establishment for the prophetic purpose of redeeming the songster's truly admirable false teeth and a prolonged visit to a house of a call at Cooja's Palace is the old Scots Hall in the parish of St. Cecily within the liberty of Sealmore, and a thousand or one national leagues that was by Griffith's valuation from the site of the statue of Hammerware Glaston, setting a match to the march of a maker, last of the Stuarts, where the tale rambled along. The trio of Wackwool the Diddlers was joined by a further intentions of a tomorrow casual and a decent sword of a had-been variety, who had just been touching the weekly insult, few it, and all fig blabbers, who saith a noun, had stimulants in the shape of ghee and geese, stood by the damned decent sword, after which stag luncheon and a few ones more, just to celebrate yesterday, flushed with their fires, tortured his friendship, the rascals came out of the licensed premises, Browns first, the small PSXX executive Cavahan, in their sad rear, like a lady's postscript, I want money, please. wiping their laugh-leaking lippers on their sleeves. How the Buckleians shout their Roskins generally.
Sean Finn, Sean Finn's alone.
And the rhymer's rule was with reason the richer for a would-be ballad. To the ballader of which the world of humanity singing owes a tribute for having placed on the planet's mama map its lay of the vilest boogier. But most attractionable avatar the world has ever had to explain for this war greatly lubing our fellow me. Leader was first poured forth where Rio Livia riots and cold hummed hums under the shadow of the monument of the should-have-been legislator Eleutheriodendron. Fair woodman's fair to an overflow meeting of all the nations in Munster, fully filling the visional area and as a single-minded supercrowd easily representative, but with masks wet with faces of all sections and cross-sections, wine shop and cocoa house poured out to brim up the broaching of our Liffyside people, to omit to mention of the mainland minority of such as had wafered via Watling, Heron, Icknell, and Stain. In chief, they halted Cockney Ear with his quarrel of hard months hacks a northern Tory, a southern Whig, an East Anglican chronicler, and a land wester guardian, ranging from slips of young Dubliners from Cutthroat's Row, having nothing better to do than walk about with their hands in their knee pants, sucking air whackers. We duly set jumbo bricks side by side with truant officers, three woolen balls and poplin in search of a crust of pond, two busy professional gentlemen, a brace of palesmen with drundreries nooning toward dailies, fresh from snipe killing and mallard missing on Rutland Heath, exchanging cold sneers, mass-going ladies from Hume Street in their chairs, the barriers baited, some wandering hammerlags out of the adjacent cold fields of Moss's Gardens, an obdurate father from Skinner's Alley, bricklayers, a Fleming, entabbered foeman with spouse and dog, an aged hammersmith who had some chiselers by the hand, a bout of cudgel players, not a few sheep with the Broxy, two blue coat scholars, four broke gentlemen out of Simpsons on the rocks, a portly and a pert still tossing turkey coffee, an orange shrub in Tickie's door, Peter Pym and Paul Fry, and then Elliot and oh, Atkinson's suffering hell's delight from the plains of their annuitants' acorns, not forgetting a deuce of Diana's ready for the hunt, a particular prebendary pondering on the Roman Easter, the tonsure question and Greek unions, punk, a lace lappet head or two or three or four from a window, and so on down to a few good old souls who, as they juiced after taking their pledge over at the uncle's place, were evidently under the spell of liquor, from the wake of Tarry the Tailor, a fairy girl, a jolly postal boy, thinking of three flagons and one up the madrol, a hexer from the weaver's almshouse who clings and clings, a chat-chat-chat clings to her, a whole dam's cloud-hued petticoat as child or curator, as Couch O'Leary, the wearer went around, so it did a nation of wands or gays, and the ballad in the Philip Rhine transcoped meter, affection by Dalcibo, it is Casunis di Palo di Chinello Altajo, stumple stamp it onto a slip of Blanco Vade, and headed by an excessively rough and red red woodcut, avidly printed at the rhyme press of Deadhill, soon fluttered its secret on white highway and brown byway to the rose of the winds and blue of the jails, from archway to lattice and from black hand to pink ear, village crying to village through the five pussy four greens of the United States of Scotia Picta, and he who delays it, may his hairs be rubbed in dirt. To the added strain so peaceful of his majesty the flute, that one crowned king in instruments, pickets, purist, cello, al saluto, which Mr. Delaney, Mr. DeLacy, horn, anticipating a perfect downpour of plaudits among the rhapsodies, piped out of his decent heart, half looking still more like his Percy full namesake, as men of Gaul noted. But before of two spit about, the snow-crested curl amoist the leader's wild and molting hair, Dr. Hitchcock hoisted his fezzy fuzz at Bludgeon's height signum to his companions of the chalice for the Lord Fellow, boys, and silentium incura, Armaypole. Once more, wary Roosevelt, and the canto was chanted there, chorused and christened, where by the old toll gate, St. Anona Street and church, and around the lawn the ran it ran, and this is the ran that Hostie made, spoken, Boyles and Cahill's, Scarrets and Pritchards, versified and piercified, may the truth we tell of live in Stony. Line the refrains of
some votin' Vike, some votin' Mike,
some dub him Lynn and Finn, while others hail him Lug, Lug, Dan, Lop, Lex, Max, Gun, or Gwyn. Some at him Arch, some bat him Barth, Col, Noel, so Will, Wheel, Wall, but I parse him Pierce O'Reilly, else he's called no name at all. Together, hurrah, leave it to Hostie, Frosty Hostie, leave it to Hostie, for he's the man who rhymed the ran, the ran, the ran, the king of all rans. Have you here? Some ha, have we where? Some hunt, have you heard? Others do, have we wear it? Others don't, it's coming, it's rubbing. The clip, the club, a la glass, crash, the click, clack, 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 glass, clack, low pass, catch, shabbat, a clippy, crutty, grand, dongs, hemi, sammy, naughty, happy, laddy, apple, dip, con, clock. Ardite, arditi, music cue, the ballad of Pierce O'Reilly.
Says you could can he manage it? I'll go bail my fine dairyman, darling, like the bumping bull of the Cassidys. All your butter is in your horns. His butter is in his horns. Butter is horns. We had chop-chop-chop shears, chewing gum, the chicken pox, and China chamber. Universally provided by the soft soaping salesman. Small wonder he'll cheat everyone. Our local kids named them when Jim then first took the floor with his bucket shop store. So Snoggy was in his hotel, brum is sumptuous. But soon will bonfire all his trash tricks and trumpery. At this short till Sheriff Clancy will be winding up his unlimited company with a bailiff's bomb at the door. Bim bam at the door. Then he'll bum no more. Sweet bad luck on the waves washed to our island. The hooker of that hammer fast Viking. The gull scarce on the day when Alabama Bay saw his black and tan man of war. Saw his man of war on the harbor bar. Where farmers pull back, cooking a pansy ball, saw him walk up the hill with picking a whip and timpani. Thinking back Oscar on a scene, Margie's bunny face, dog skin gamble. Chickers moniker, all guys I are at Kevin Norwegian Chickers Con, old Norwegian Camel Con, he is my God. It was during some fresh water garden bumping, according to the nursing mirror of my room, the monkeys, that our heavyweight heathen hung furry, they pulled up me to woo, woo-hoo, what'll she do? The general lost her maiden blue. He ought to blush for himself, the old hay-headed philosopher, for to go and shove himself that way on top of her. May God, he's the crux of the catalog of our antediluvial zoo. Messrs. Billing and Clue, Noah's larks good as new. He was jolting by Wellington's monument, our notorious hippopotamus, when some bugger let down the backdrop of the omnibus, and he caught his death of fusilled years with his rent in his rears. Give him 6 years to sort pity for his innocent poor children, but look out for his Mrs. Legitimate. When that fruit gets a grip of old earwicker, won't there be earwigs on the green? Big earwig on the green, the largest ever you've seen.
Sophocles, ships of power.
Then we'll have the free trade jails band and mass meetings, for to saw the brave son of Scandinavery. And we'll bury him down in Oxman's town, along with the devil and Danes, with the deaf and dumb Danes, and all their remains. Not all the king's men's nor horses will resurrect his corpus, for there's no true spell in Connachar Hell that's able to raise a cane.